When it comes to competitive, season 5 has changed just about everything. Starting from this season's FNCS, the rest of the tournaments for the entire year are going to be in the trios format. Yo, this sounds pretty intimidating, right? What's going on, guys? Butcher Crunch Charmation Motivation Guy, and today we're going to be breaking down everything that you and your trio needs to do in order to succeed in the Fortnite trios. You guys ready for this? Let's get this going.
What might be the most important step that you're gonna need to take to make sure that you succeed in trio events going forward is making sure that you actually have the perfect teammates. Obviously, like when it comes to playing a team game mode, all right, you're gonna be relying on your teammates quite a bit, right? So if you can't work together, well, you're gonna be out of luck, man. There are many ways to find good teammates, but you'll probably have the best luck through Discord and social media, primarily through servers like the East Open, where you can just post your resume. Now, I probably know what you're thinking. A resume? Am I applying for a job? The answer is yeah. Like, you kind of have to look at it that way. Like, when it comes to finding good teammates, you need to prove that you got what it takes to benefit on their team. So a Fortnite resume should show all of your achievements and skills, which will allow other people to evaluate, you know, whether they want you on their team or, you know, if you're a good fit, usually based on your past earnings and even placement rankings. But hey, don't feel bad, man, if you don't have the most experience in the world, because when it comes to choosing your teammates, you know, it should be more about where you want to go in the future, not where you've been. So try playing with whoever reaches out to you and just really make sure that you prove that you have what it takes to keep up with them, and equally so with them. Make sure that you're playing with someone that can keep up with you. I mean, it's not just all about the skills though. You should also be keeping track of your new potential teammates' mindsets and play style as well. Mindsets and play style, so important. Like, are they constantly, you know, raging out whenever something doesn't go their way? Or when someone makes a mistake, does their playstyle complement your playstyle? If they're always raging and, you know, they don't play in a way that is beneficial to you and, you know, makes you motivated to keep playing, then you might not have the best choice there. Chemistry is just as important as skill, man. You need to enjoy playing and practicing with them. It shouldn't be something that makes you anxious. It shouldn't be something that you don't look forward to and it's a burden. No, you're excited to play with your teammates. All right, so that brings us to our second tip. You need to learn how to practice efficiently. So if you got no idea on what you should be doing when it comes to practicing, you could take the best shortcut by coming on over to ProGuys.com. Yeah, we say it every video because it's that important. We've got a brand new master course by Clix. If you haven't checked it out, what are you waiting for, guys? And we also got coaches that are tailored to help your needs, available 24/7 to help you guys improve quickly. So click the card in the top right to learn more, like right now. All right, so when you're practicing, the thing that you have to keep in mind is making sure that you are both efficient and productive. Fortnite is a game and it's a whole lot of fun to play, right? But that doesn't mean that you should just always be just goofing around when you're practicing if you're looking to succeed in competitive modes, especially in trios. So if you take a look at the professional players, like, what do you see? What do you see when you look at them? You're going to see a whole lot of dedicated individuals that spend at least 6 hours, you know, a day trying to be the best. And while not everyone can play for that long, I get it. You do have a life, you do have school, you maybe have a job, like maybe your parents won't let you play that long. Whatever it is, you know, you still try to practice as much as you can. So after you found your trio, you need to be playing Arena, scrimming and practicing in creative together as often as you can. So Arena is a fantastic method to improve that is always open and available to you. And it'll put you up against opponents at a similar skill level too, which is exactly what you need when trying to level up your fighting abilities. It's time to level up. I've been saying it, gotta take it to the next level. So you're gonna come across all different types of teams, which are gonna help your trio work together and just really learn how to fight with synergy. Ooh, so important. Scrims are a totally different ball game. People playing in distinctly different ways in scrims to an arena, and it's a way that will be much more similar to higher levels of tournament play. These games are going to be great for in-game practice, teaching you exactly how the highest level of players acts in in-game. Just remember, guys, you gotta focus on arena as well, or you'll never actually make it to the in-game in the first place. Practicing in creative is also a great way to train your skills. Just remember that you're practicing for real games, all right? There's no point in practicing insane builds in creative if you're never actually going to be able to pull them off in the game. You're just wasting your time. In creative though, like, you know, it'd be smart to play against your teammates so you could just learn each other's strengths and learn each other's weaknesses. All right, so once everybody has a good grasp on what each other's play style and ability and limits are in the trio, your next step to grinding your trio into a powerhouse of competitive is to start choosing your roles. Remember, choosing your roles. In a competitive game of trios, there will always be, you know, three roles for your team. An IGL, a fragger, and a support. All right, here we go. Take note. The IGL is basically the brain of the team. Okay, they make all the decisions. A good IGL will be able to set up the team's positioning and tarps to make sure your trio is always ahead of the fight. The IGL will constantly be thinking of three steps ahead of everybody else in an attempt to keep your team together and in the game. Next up, guys, is the fragger. Here we go. The role for the best fighter on the team and will always be looking for, you know, to get refreshes and picks. The fragger will tend to just stay at the back of the tarp and will almost always start the fight off. Okay, so a fragger will usually carry a sniper and has to be set up to win all their fights. Who does the setting up? Well, that should be the support player. So the supporter, you know, helps the team stay alive through carrying the most heals and mobility. You might pass the support role off as a boring or unskilled, but that's not the case at all, man. The support player still needs to fight well while also making sure that the rest of the team has a good amount of mats and heals as well. Because the support will usually have the most heals on them, they're usually the last one alive, and will almost always go for a heal off at the finish. So after you choose what role you guys think suits you guys, the role that you think you're the best at, you need to stick to what corresponds with the end game, all right? Never get too selfish while playing and try to branch out into other players' territory. Stay in your role, stay in your lane. Keeping a good mindset is a huge part of playing Fortnite as well in general. Obviously, I'm your motivation guy. This is all I talk about, right? Is your mindset, because with the wrong mindset, it really doesn't matter how good you are. Like, I know a lot of talented, skillful players, unfortunately, that will never make it really, really big because no matter what, they practice all they want. They could play as many hours as they want a day. But because they have such a discouraging mindset, a negative mindset, it's almost like they just sabotage themselves. And so your mindset is everything, guys. Remember that. So your mindset is important, but even more when it comes to trios. Having a good mental game is the key to succeeding in an intense situation, especially when there's money on the line. You better not play with my money. Don't play with my money, man. Staying positive and remembering that anything can happen is a great way to stay motivated. And just remember, guys, it's never really over until you think it is. A major part of team game modes, man, is keeping your positivity up, you know, by cracking jokes and try to enjoy your game. Like, if you're not having fun, nothing else is gonna work. So anything can happen at any moment in just one pop-off game, completely just saving your tournament run, which is incredible, easy to do. No, basically, never let yourself become demotivated and always try to stay on top of your game. Like, if you want to know more about keeping a good mindset while playing Fortnite, you need to follow me on Instagram. That's the first thing, because I'm putting up posts all the time encouraging guys to be great, all right? And you should also, you know, check out the previous video that we did as well, and it's gonna help you guys a lot. The last thing that we're gonna mention in today's video is something that helps every single player in any game mode, really at any skill level, and that's VOD reviewing. Yeah, I say it all the time, but you know what? If you're not doing it a lot, you need to listen again. VOD reviewing is when you look back at the videos of previous games that you've played, making sure to focus on any of the mistakes that you've made while comparing your gameplay to games from others who've performed well. VOD reviewing is for those who are humble, who are hungry, who are determined to be better every single day. You know what I mean? And so I'm talking to you. I'm talking to those that really want to take their game to the next level, who are serious, you know, who think they got what it takes to make it to the top. I'm talking to you. VOD reviewing is one of the ultimate tools for improvement, and it really allows you to hyper focus on all of your mistakes, meaning you can just fix them and never let them cost you games in the future. Fortnite has a super simple option for this, you know, baked into the game. Like, all you need to do is just make sure you have your replays turned on. You can then just go into the replay from Fortnite itself to see exactly what you did wrong and how you can do things differently. And while you're watching, guys, you should also make sure to write down notes. Yes, I know we write down notes in school. I get it. But you know what? It's something about writing something down where it really does help you memorize it. Like, and not only memorize it, it just gets into your heart, it gets into your mind, so that when you're in the game, you actually start executing it. And that's how we actually get better. So writing down notes is huge. And it also helps you to let you know what you did wrong in the tournament. All right, next, you gotta find a successful player that has streamed their games and plays in a similar way to you, and then check their VODs or YouTube highlights out. So by comparing what you do and what they do in similar situations, you're gonna be able to identify your own issues way easier. But if you don't know what you're looking for when it comes to reviewing bots, like if you don't know what kind of mistakes that you should be looking for, it can be very difficult to actually end up fixing them, right? Well, that's where ProGuys.com really comes in again. Like with our innovative VOD review system, you can upload your VODs directly to the ProGuys website, where a pro will watch it over and just give you a report based on everything that you did right and wrong. And it's one of the fastest ways to improve as well. All right, ProGuys family, let's do a recap. In the future, every FNCS Cash Cup this year is going to be played in the trios format. To succeed, you need to find the perfect trio, practice with them efficiently, and choose and stick to your roles. Have a good mindset and review your VODs. Guys, if you do all five, improvement is going to be guaranteed. Hey, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like. Bunch of Crunch Army, man, spread the word to subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you soon.